In 2018, I decided that I was going to completely change my lifestyle and go off-grid in the west of Ireland. A lot of people have been asking me about my bills in the current climate and how my project is going and have I saved any money. Honestly, I know I have, but I've never pulled all the numbers together until now. So I finally dived in, got all the information together and made a video about it. My heating, hot water, electricity, electric car charging, everything. I know I saved thousands in 2022, which I hadn't even realized. The video will follow on from here, or maybe you need to link to it from a QR code, depending on where you're watching this introduction. Since the energy crisis has escalated, I've been asked by several people what my current energy bills living off-grid look like. So here's a short video on that very subject. First of all, it's important to stress that my decision to go off-grid was what I believed would be significant gas price increases and hence significant electricity price increases in the future. This would be due to European Union and world green energy policies on wind and solar on the grid from now to 2050 and the billions in investments we will all have to pay for. In addition, renewable energy grids require a gas grid to underpin them, and if everyone wants new gas at the same time, it will be scarce and it will be expensive. It was just basic logic. At least 12 brand new gas-fired power stations were announced in Ireland just in 2022 alone. From mid-2021, gas prices had already started that trend upwards due to increased demand, and it was nothing to do with Ukraine. And now we have to buy LNG at 5 times the price of the previous cheap Russian gas to add to the pain. These are simply the realities that everyone is facing right now. The era of cheap energy is over. I made another video about the equipment and how all that works, so I'm just going to focus on this video on bills and how I use the system. I need heating, hot water and electricity for my house, just like everybody else. And in my case, I'm also charging multiple electric vehicles in rural west of Ireland. This home is of 2006 vintage and approximately 4,500 square feet. Today is Tuesday, March the 7th, and a major cold snap again with freezing temperatures. Luckily, I have a renewable thermal central heating system on my roof, which is running my original central heating radiators all day, totally free of cost. So even though it's frosty cold weather, my thermal electric array on the roof is 74 degrees Celsius, and that's direct feeding my central heating radiators with 61 degrees temperature, so pretty hot, hotter than a regular boiler. I do have an electric boiler which can operate in hybrid mode with the thermal system, but it's clearly off today because it's completely unnecessary. This system will run from morning till evening and it doesn't cost a penny, so my heating is free today. At 23 minutes past 9 this morning, the system is already over 60 degrees, hotter than a boiler. By 10 a.m. over 71 degrees, and then by 20 past 10 it was over 76 degrees. This is the power of this system. Here you can see all the internal temperatures. House is very, very warm. All that heat came, 100% came from renewable heating on the roof. Completely free, cost absolutely nothing. The weather outside is cold. It's currently around 5 degrees. Wind chill feeling zero, but very frosty weather overnight. It's now 20 past 8 in the evening. Obviously the house is still very warm from today. All the walls have soaked up the heat. It's -1 currently. It's supposed to go to -4. So right now our radiator is still running at 52 degrees, but now we're running off our electric boiler. It's currently in standby at the moment because temperature is made, and our hot water temperature is 51 degrees. Our electric boiler, we could set it at whatever setting if we wanted it to work at 60 degrees. We just turn it up and it'll come back in, and now it'll actually lift the radiator temperature up to 60 degrees. We don't really need that right now, but it's a very flexible system and this is all free electricity. So 15 minutes later and the system has now brought the radiators up to 60 degrees and the system is that easy to operate. The boiler now, electric boiler, has now gone back into standby mode. So we're going to jump forward 2 days to March the 9th just to highlight how we do heating differently. We had a blizzard on this day all day. And we use the system completely differently. As you can see, a lot of the panels are covered in snow. It's very cold, a very, very heavy moisture-bearing cloud overhead. And it's very, very cold outside. negative temperatures. You can see our collectors still only about 2 degrees Celsius. And our heating system radiators are 58 degrees, hot water 58 degrees. Now, we're not doing that with renewable thermal today on a day like this because it literally every bit of energy is blocked from the sky. But our electric boiler is doing it from our renewable electricity system and our battery storage system. So even though it's really, really cold, snowing, it's 11:15 at night, the house is still toasty warm, and we did it differently today. We used renewable electricity from our battery system today because there was no thermal energy available. As those 2 days were real extreme examples of heating performance from the thermal system, here's an example on an ordinary day. So 72 degrees production temperatures into the heating system, and it's overcast, windy and breezy, but not on typical weather, just to give you an example of this. I should just mention that these panels are not standard panels, both electric and thermal. They're designed to harvest diffuse light. They're extremely powerful and designed for buildings. And as we can see, even on an overcast day like today, March the 30th, production temperatures, 78 degrees Celsius, all free into the heating system. And the boiler, electric boiler, which is again renewable, isn't even required again today. So what does our heating system look like? Obviously, we have our thermal electric panels on the roof. Those top panels feed our central heating system and radiators and hot water. They make heat and electricity, currently the highest rated on the market. Then we have our electric boiler feeding from our renewable electricity and battery system. And then we have our micro HVO boiler, which runs in HVO or kerosene. You can't actually buy kerosene boilers anymore. And HVO is a biofuel available in the UK and Northern Ireland, soon to be available in the Republic of Ireland. So let's look at what our historical purchasing of heating fuel for kerosene is. In 2017, we bought 300 litres. We paid €189. In 2019, we bought 75 litres for €51. In 2020, we literally filled the tank because the price had crashed. So we took advantage of that. It was only 3.9 cents a kilowatt hour, or 39 cents a litre. That cost us €235. And then a couple of days ago, we just filled it again. So we're going to exclude what's in green because that's actually still in the tank. And we did that because we have a 650 litre tank and we wanted to see how much of this original 603 litres was remaining. So about 150 litres was still in the tank. We could only get 500 litres into it. So we're going to deduct 100 litres from this just to do the calculations to get a more accurate picture. And that works out over 5.5 years, 878 litres of kerosene, which is 8,780 kilowatt hours. You just multiply it by 10, which we purchased for heat and hot water. So over the 5.5 years, we spent for €435. And that works out at 159 litres a year on average, or 79 euros per year, or €6.58 per month, like €6.58 a month for all of our additional heating that we didn't do ourselves from renewables. So we look at our scoreboard. We're going to scoreboard everything in terms of our bills for the last 5.5 years. Our original E1 energy rating shows that we needed to consume 56,752 kilowatt hours of delivered energy for that year, for primary heat, for secondary heating, and for hot water, which at current pricing means would cost us €6,186 a year. After the retrofit, which again was focused on an energy retrofit with some fabric, not a fabric retrofit, the SEI data shows that we should be now consuming 12,280 kilowatt hours of delivered energy per year for our heating and hot water, which would work out at €1,339 per year. And one big difference is when we originally started this retrofit, the house was 201 square meters. It's now 450 square meters. And then on the third line, we actually see what we are spending. So we spent €79 a year on average over the last 5.5 years. It's our total spend on extra heating. So if you look at, that's an annual saving at current prices of €6,107. So if you go back to our original E1, if we'd done nothing to the house, that's what we'd be paying right now. And instead of that, we're only paying €79 a year, which is a fantastic saving. Now we move on to electricity, and as I already said, I did another video on all the equipment installed. I'm just focusing on bills and use in this one. We obviously make lots of free electricity, and it allows us to do things for free that are normally quite expensive. But we use special three-dimensional semiconductor electricity panels, which don't have to face south and are tuned to harvest diffuse daylight instead of sunlight. If we use standard solar PV panels, we'd have no electricity in winter. The data clearly shows the performance difference. Let's look at March the 7th again. We produced 77.7 kilowatt hours and peaked at 16.7 kilowatt output on the day. Generation started at 7:30 a.m. and finished at 6:30 p.m. That's 11 hours of generation, which is incredible for the time of year. We're going to jump back to March the 9th. Just look at production on that day. So this was the really blizzardy, snowy day. Everything on the roof is covered with snow. It's very dark skies. Really, really low light levels. But we would still expect to get all of our electricity that day. So you can see we're doing 1.1 kilowatt output at this moment. Nearly coming up on 10 kilowatt hours for the day produced. That's how amazing these panels are from a production and performance point of view. Even this type of weather can't stop them. So let's jump forward to the March the 11th. We're at the tail end of this blizzard. It's now turning to heavy rain and wind. It's a really dark, dreary, wet day all day. We would still expect to get all of our energy today, regardless of this weather being so bad. We're currently doing 2.4 kilowatts. This three-dimensional semiconductor panels are so amazing at pulling in energy. We can see 4.3 kilowatts earlier, over 6 kilowatts earlier. So as the clouds are shape-shifting, this technology is sucking in the energy at different levels all day. So to give you a sense of how powerful this 3D semiconductor panel is, if we assumed it was going to rain like this for 60 days, that's the length of a bi-monthly electricity bill. So we're already at 15 kilowatt hours produced today at lunchtime. We can assume we will double that by the end of the day. So this would equate to having generated 792 euros worth of electricity if we take the current rate of 44 cents. So that's how much electricity we would have created if we kept going with this really bad weather for the duration of 2 months. So we can see, even with all the rain and everything else, our battery system, which carries a week's amount of electricity, is at 80%. It's still only lunchtime, so it's charging. So the battery of the 2.8 we're producing just this minute, 2 kilowatts are going into the battery. We're obviously consuming 800 watts in the property at the moment. We don't really watch this stuff, but this is the data we have in the background. So we get fantastic data from the system. We can see absolutely everything, every day, every minute, every hour. It's quite an elaborate piece of information. You can see we use about 18,000 kilowatt hours per year on average now for the last 3 years. This is our first 3 months of the year. You can see January, February performance quite strong. That's a symptom or of the panels we're using. You can see last October, November, December, virtually the same amount of performance. And that's because this three-dimensional semiconductor daylight absorbing panel is operates differently. You'd expect solar PV to kind of crash out in December and January. And of course, we need that because we need electricity in the depths of winter as well to keep the house running. Just to see how crazy the performance is, look at this January data. January 1st, 35 kilowatt hours. January 2nd, 19. January 3rd, 58. The 4th, 59. 5th, 58. 6th, 46. Then 7th, 40. 8th, 37. This is all the first 2 weeks of January. We only need 10 kilowatt hours a day because we have LED lighting to survive and we keep a week's amount of electricity. But just to see how powerful these panels are, this just simply wouldn't work if it was solar PV. We need these panels because we need power in the depths of winter. And all the data shows how powerful these panels are. So we're going to work up the electricity information now. March the 30th, we've consumed 2,751 so far this year. But if we go back to last year, the full year, 18,258. So 17,000-18,000 seems to be the kind of norm for a full year's consumption for us. The first year was only a part year, 2018. Our total generation then is 78,394 kilowatt hours so far. So we're going to work that up now in terms of what that looks like in numbers. So when it comes to savings and bills and everything else, we use our electricity production for both electric vehicle charging, fuel electric cars, and normal electricity consumption, and that includes our electric boiler. So it's generally about 50-50. So in 2022, 50% of our electricity consumption was 9,129.5 kilowatt hours, and at 0.44 cent per kilowatt hour, that works out at 4,016 euros and 98 cents of electricity we made ourselves that we didn't have to buy. And our total to date on the whole system, which is just over 4 years and 9 months, is 39,197 kilowatt hours. And if we had to buy that at 44 cents, that value would be 17,246 euros that we wouldn't have spent since we put in the system. Now, electricity was cheaper earlier on, but it's also going to be more expensive as well. So this is going to actually, every year, this is going to get bigger and bigger, the amount of money that we don't spend. So we're going to add electricity into our scoreboard now. We've self-generated electricity, 39,197 kilowatt hours. That's the half of all of our electricity we use for electrical stuff. So at today's prices, that's worth 17,246. We've purchased from the grid zero since April 2018. When we went off grid, we went off grid, and our panels are so good they generate through winter. Our last bill was 731 in 2018. Two electric cars, rural Ireland, clocks up a lot of electricity because you do high mileage, you do a lot of battery charging. And all we've done is kept the electricity connection there at the backup, never used it, just paid the standing charges as we go. And even our current bill, obviously, we're now owed 325 euros because of the government pushback in terms of payments. So now looking at our EV charging, 2022, but 9,129 kilowatt hours for vehicle charging. Now that works out at 77 cent per kilowatt hour. The first place you need to put your own electricity is into an EV. An EV uses about 15 kilowatt hours for every 100 kilometers. A brand new modern car uses 7 liters of fuel for every 100 kilometers. So basically, 7 liters of fuel equals 15 kilowatt hours. So we divide 1155 using the current price of 165 by 15, and we get 77 cents per kilowatt hour. So every electricity kilowatt hour I put into an EV, I'm actually saving myself 77 cents in purchasing. So 2002, we avoided 7,029.71 in avoided petrol diesel charges for charging three EVs. The total to date, the other half of our total electricity at 39,197 kilowatt hours is worth 30,181 to us based on those numbers. Now, they're not 150, you know, has been an average for petrol and diesel for quite some time, and it's been obviously an awful lot higher as well. We're going to add that now to the scoreboard. So if we look at our scoreboard currently with everything on it now, so in the last 5 years, we can see we've saved 30,000, over 30,000 euros in heating costs since we retrofitted, kind of using today's prices. We've generated 17,000 euros worth of our own electricity for power use, and we've avoided petrol diesel purchasing of over 30,000 as well, all again using current pricing. So that's 77,000 euros at today's pricing. So maybe the number is slightly smaller than that, but it's still a huge number. And we're only 5 years into this project. This is going to go on, and every year the savings are going to get bigger and bigger as energy gets more expensive. And that's just going to leave so much more money behind that we don't have to spend. So this is the final tally, 17,154 savings for year 2022 on heating, electricity and petrol, avoided purchasing. 5 year total, 77,962 euros. Again, that's using current pricing. So the number's going to be slightly smaller, but it's still going to be a huge number. Return on investment is now coming in at 6 years for the project, and it's got a 45-year project window. Electronics warranty is 15 years, panel warranty is 25 years, and even that, they're still working at that point. So that's the kind of final total tally on the whole project. The reality is, you've got to make a decision what kind of lifestyle you want. Do you want to spend all your money paying other people for energy, or do you want to do something about it? Because it really will define your lifestyle. Geopolitics, and you can see that right now, I mean, is easily ripping money away from people with expensive energy, and that's unlikely to change in the future. Remember, It wasn't raining when Noah built the ark, so your future will be secured by whatever decisions you take today for you and your family. And those decisions are best taken before a crisis. The last year alone should have demonstrated this to you. Thank you for watching. Fana Savolce. If you want to watch the video I made about all the equipment, a walkthrough of that, you can just scan the QR code in front of you, and that will take you directly to that video on YouTube.